So I'm here with Derek Hoare and Rilana Cima to tell you a little bit about ESIT. Derek, what is ESIT?
So ESIT is a doctoral training program. So that is a large fund provided by the European Union to support 15 PhD students. We're all working on tinnitus.
Yes. Yeah. And what's your role in ESIT?
So I'm the training coordinator currently. So I organise training activities and training events. So we're currently in Milano for a one-week training event with all of those students. So the students, it's quite a novel approach. All of the students have moved from a country to a different country. All of those being placed somewhere in Europe. So every 6 months we all come together and have an intensive week of specialist training. So this week we're training on communicating your research ideas and developing funding applications.
And Rilana, what's your role in ESIT?
I'm one of the supervisors of one of those PhD students. So, meaning that I was able to hire a talented student from, Brazil actually, studying in Portugal, who came all the way to Maastricht to follow a PhD program of 3 years, in which I can work together with him on doing several very specialized and exciting new studies into clinical interventions for tinnitus. Yeah, that is my role. And I am now here as well in Milan because at some points during the project, all the supervisors meet together as well to see how it's going. Since I am one of the supervisors of one of the PhD students, there's 15, all from different nationalities, different genders, different cultural backgrounds, different
disciplines.
Very important. So it's interdisciplinary. Yeah. So we have basic researchers, intervention researchers, technicians. We have data specialists, computer scientists, animal research people, all coming together. So it's quite something.
Yeah, that's quite exciting. Yeah, Derek, how is it going so far?
Well, we're just at the midpoint. Mm. So all of our students are now 18 months or so into their PhDs,
yeah.
Which means they've all got their studies set up and approved. Many of them are collecting data and some of them are even publishing papers already. Yeah. In fact, one of our students yesterday had his third paper already accepted, just 18 months into his PhD.
Mm.
I think they've really formed excellently as a group. So I can see we have a large group of researchers here interested in tinnitus who will continue to work and collaborate together beyond the period of their PhD. So I think some very exciting times and outputs ahead.
Mm. Yeah. What are expected to be the ultimate, or what do you hope will be the ultimate outcomes of ESIT?
I hope that we can have, as we have talked about earlier as well, is that there's many different types of research going on in tinnitus, the more mechanical or basic research, the interventional research, the lab research with animals. And I hope we can integrate all this knowledge and feed it into the new generation of researchers so it doesn't stay as fragmented as was. So the added benefit is we have the combination of all these disciplines and research areas together. So I hope that after this project, as Derek already said, that many of them will seek collaborations in applying, for example, for new projects, new funding, who will then tackle problems in different areas and try to get the knowledge and together to come to very innovative new ways of treating tinnitus patients, obviously. Yeah.
Absolutely. I think it's somewhat experimental in mm-hmm. the level of interdisciplinarity that we have within the ESIT program, but we can already see that it's working.
Yeah.
And there is new learning emerging already for the researchers as well as for the students. So yeah. Exciting times.
Yeah,
very, very exciting. Thank you very much.